Athletic Commission. The judges, Artie Idala and Frank Forbes. The timekeeper, Freddie Abatello. Counting for the knockdown, Zach Clayton. Referee for the main event, Joe Loscalzo. 10 rounds. Introducing from Louisville, Kentucky. He's wearing white trunks. He weighs 202. And a half pounds, Cassius Clay. His opponent from New York City, wearing black trunks, he weighs 188, Doug Jones. Main event, 10 rounds.
Cassius Clay, Doug Jones, you have been briefed by the New York State Athletic Commissioner, General Coolidge. Are there any questions? Okay, touch gloves, return to your respective corners, and come out boxing at the sound of the bell. Good luck.
And here we go with a scheduled 10-round bout. The second-ranked heavyweight on the left, in white trunks, Cassius Clay. In the black trunks, waiting to come out, Doug Jones, who is ranked third. 14 and a half pounds lighter, Jones in black. Cassius Clay is 3 inches taller. He's in the white trunks, 6'3". Watch his speedy left hand. He's got a beauty. And don't forget, should this bout end in a knockout, we'll have a videotape rerun of the round. You just saw one of Clay's habits, pulling away from punches instead of trying to slip them. This may cause him trouble. Jones in black, 188. Clay, 202 and a half, and there it is! A good solid punch. And just as we mentioned, pulling away from punches. We've got about 2 minutes to go in round one. Minute and 45 seconds, round one. A good left hook by Clay. About a minute to go. Round one. 45 seconds. There's that beautiful left jab by Cassius Clay. A glancing right hand. Seconds left in round one. Cassius Clay was definitely shaken up by a shot that caught him as he was backing away from a punch instead of trying to slip it, as we pointed out. He's talking to his trainer, Angelo Dundee. Jimmy Wilde is on the outside of the ropes. Chickie Ferrara is to the right of Dundee. Clay, in marvelous condition at 202 and a half pounds, is fighting a very determined Doug Jones. Jones caught one left hook that was Clay's big punch of round one. Jones has been knocked down previously. He is just off a seventh round knockout victory over Zora Foley. He's a boy that can take it. He's never been stopped, and the same is true of undefeated Clay. We get ready now for round two. Nearly 19,000 looking on at Madison Square Garden. Hope you're enjoying it. Unusual for Clay to have as his only defense backing away from punches. Yeah. 2 minutes to go, round two. These are heavyweights punching with the speed of lightweights. About a minute to go in round two. Neither fighter is cut. Clay has never been cut in his boxing career. Jones, several times. Seconds left in round two. The bell in 10 seconds. This is Chris Schenkel of ringside, Madison Square Garden, as we look at Doug Jones, born right here in New York City 26 years ago. And as you see, he is most certainly an orthodox fighter, very even-tempered, quiet, plods along, as you have seen, and he knows of Cassius Clay's one glaring fault, and consequently has been using that left hook off a jab. This is a boy that knows how to carry the fight to his opponent, and that's what he's been doing. His opponent, Cassius Clay, as we await the start of round three, doesn't seem any the worse for a heavy punch that he took in the first round. He is off a third round knockout over Charlie Powell. He has knocked out his last nine opponents, most by prophesying the round. Tonight he has predicted round four. Here's the third round of a Schedule 10. Cassius Clay, the favorite, despite the more experience of Doug Jones. Minutes left, round three. Clay now really using that left hand to advantage, keeping Jones off balance. Glancing punches, some picked off by Jones. Minutes ago in the third round. One, two by Clay. 45 seconds left in the round. Bell in 10 seconds. Clay, undoubtedly the most colorful fighter since Maxie Bear. He's the man that has sold out Madison Square Garden. In fact, there are 598 more people here tonight than there were at the last sellout in 1957 when Sugar Ray Robinson fought Gene Fulmer. It's the first time in the history of this sports palace that the fight has been sold out prior to the day of it. A man who has captured the imagination of everybody across the country. People from all walks of life here at the Garden tonight. Lauren Bacall, John Daly, Mrs. Bob Hope, Jason Robards, Cook Shard, all sorts of folks who are eating up the action. We hope you are too. This is the fourth round at the Garden. Clay in white originally predicted a knockout in six, but then he decided to cut it down to four. This is the fourth round. about 2 minutes to go in round four. Jones is going to be a tough one to knock out in any round. Clay appearing a little tired right now after the volley punching. With 45 seconds to go in the round. Jones' attack thus far has been forward, as you've noticed. He's been trained that way against a backing up Clay. Remaining in the fifth round. No cuts, no knockdowns. Good right hand shot by Clay. Solid right by Jones. Come on. 40 seconds to go. They're both tiring here in the fifth. amazing that one of the fighters is not cut. Unmarked, both of them. Less than 1 minute, round six. Tonight in a state that practically outlawed boxing 2 weeks ago. And here you have a standing room crowd only at Madison Square Garden, which is credit to this 21-year-older and of a dozen leaders of Kentucky industry led by Bill Faversham, who is the manager of record. They have done a tremendous job handling a very likable young heavyweight at 202 and a half tonight. Jones, 188. Round seven. Schedule 10. By the way, these are 8-ounce gloves. and a half. Left in the seventh. One of the few times that Clay has grabbed on to catch his breath. White has gone 10 rounds twice in his career. Jones in the black trunks once went 15 rounds in a light heavyweight title bout with Carol Johnson. Ten seconds. Square Garden, there are 18,732 fans, a gate of 104,943, and our closed-circuit television covering about 39 cities around the country, two pay television locations, community antenna systems. We're awfully proud of that, and of course, awfully pleased with the great work done by Bill King of Louisville, Kentucky, who staged and promoted the first professional bout that this young man was in, Cassius Clay. Here is Doug Jones, who has 13 knockouts to his credit in 25 fights, while Clay has 14 in an undefeated slate. Jones would appear to have the edge now, even though he went into the fight as the underdog. He seems to be a boy of great stamina, and he has proven that he has ample durability and determination as we go into round 8 at the Garden. As you've seen, has thrown many, many punches, many combinations, most of which have been ill-timed, having little effect. Good facial defense by Jones, though. Look at the difference. Clay with his hands low, Jones keeping them up for protection and in hitting position. Round 8 of a 10-round fight, scheduled for 10, with 2 minutes to go in the 8th round. Both fighters were very, very much interested to know that Sonny Liston and Floyd Patterson were watching this bout. Trouble. seconds to go. Seconds. Clay momentarily shaken up, but seems to be in top condition and is warding it off. Ladies and gentlemen, the Boxing Education and Research Foundation is engaged in a program aimed at the establishment of a retirement plan for boxers. This nonprofit voluntary organization already has obtained the cooperation of boxing promoters throughout the country. More help is needed, and we appeal to you as fight fans to add your support to this worthwhile cause. No salaries are paid any officials of the Boxing Education and Research Foundation, but there is a need for funds to further its current study, which will lead to a retirement fund for fighters. Send your contributions to Commissioner Harry W. Falk, Post Office Box 540, Ukiah, California, spelled U-K-I-A-H. Box 540, Ukiah, California, to Commissioner Harry W. Falk. Now we get set for round 9 of the Schedule 10. Cassius Clay, little arm weary now. Trying for a knockout. Come on, 10 seconds of much needed rest. Hope you're enjoying it, wherever you may be. Jimmy August, Alex Koskowitz, and Rolly Hackmer are working on a durable Doug Jones. We've been very impressed with his great defense. Cassius Clay getting the full treatment here before the start of the final round to freshen him up. He shot the works in the ninth round, trying for a knockout. Artie Idala, Frank Forbes are the two judges. Joe Lascalzo is the referee. The 10th round coming up, possibility of a decision or even a draw. Well, let's see what happens as we go into the final stages. Jones is a little rubbery legged. He's taken a lot of good shots to the head. We have a minute and 40 seconds left in the fight. 1:40 to go. Point must system is in effect here in the event of a draw. And then only will it help in the determination. The rounds are even, then they use the point system. And that could happen here. We have 1 minute to go in the bout. Beautiful finish. Seconds. Lascalzo. Neither fighter was knocked down. Neither fighter sustained any cuts, which is great credit to a tremendous job of physical conditioning by Angelo Dundee in the case of Cassius Clay at home we're looking now. And Rolly Hackner, Jimmy August, manager Alex Koskowitz on the part of Doug Jones. It's been a while since we've seen a fighter that has taken as many punches and seemingly as just brush them off like water off a duck's back. Doug Jones, who lost only 3 in 25, Clay going into this bout undefeated in 17 starts. Johnny Addy now has collected the cards. First of Artie Idala, and now of Frank Forbes, and he is getting it verified by the executive inspector, Jack Duberstein, and Secretary Dan Dowd, as we look at Cassius Clay, who is directly above us, shouting to some of his fans. He put on a tremendous finishing flurry in that 10th and final round. There is Doug Jones, the 26-year-old holder who grew up right here in New York City. And now for the decision. Here is Johnny Addy.
Both judges, Addy Eisenhower and Frank Forbes, they score it this way. 5-4-1 even favor of Clay. Referee Joe LaScalza has it. 8-8-1, one even, Clay. Winner by unanimous decision, Cassius Clay.
There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. 5-4-1 on the part of the two judges at ringside, and 8-1-1 on the part of the referee, Joe LaScalza. We're going up in the ring now to get a with Cassius Clay. As soon as the pictures are taken, ladies and gentlemen, he is a very happy victor. Angelo Dundee is the man on Cassius Clay's right. Cassius Clay is mimicking some of the people who are booing the decision, while Doug Jones very nonchalantly says anything. Debris is coming into the ring now. And here is the man that won it. Unanimous decision. He is mugging the still cameras here. Cassius, what a battle.
Thank you very much.
Turn up this way. How was it?
Well, this fellow surprised me. I predicted four. What am I? I had him going in four, but he's just tougher than I thought he was. Can't call them all. But I understand Sonny Liston is watching this fight. And as soon as I get to Miami, I want that bomb, and he will fall at eight.
Cassius, would you like to meet this boy again before you get listed?
Bad.
All right. What are your plans now?
Well, my plans are to go back to Louisville, Kentucky, take care of business, and go on back to Miami to take care of training to Liston.
You did a very good job. Nice going.
Thank you very much.
Very good. Cassius Clay, ladies and gentlemen, who won it 5-4-1 on the cards of the two judges and 8-1-1 on the card of the referee. Doug Jones is in the corner. Doug Jones is over here. Doug Jones being swung around for the photographers. Doug, not being expected to be talked to, we'll try to get his reaction as soon as some of the still pictures are taken. Doug did a very good job. Doug, that was a tough loss for you. How did you feel about it? Were you hurt at any time?
No, not at all. I don't like to move. I just couldn't seem to get off. I really wanted to. Actually, I don't like to make any excuses. I don't know what the reason was why I couldn't get on.
Doug, I think you have one of the great defenses in boxing, and you also have proven that you're a durable fighter. Were you hurt at any time?
No, not at all. As I said, I just couldn't seem to get off like I wanted to. I wasn't hurt at any time. That's what actually kept me going.
How would you rate Clay with the other heavyweights that you fought? I know he beat you, but
yes.
Not considering
that. I wouldn't rate him as well as the rest of them that I fought. But, as I said, I don't like to make excuses, and I don't want to begin now. But as I said, I don't know what reason why I couldn't actually get off.
You gave a great performance. You're a fine boxer.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Doug Jones, ladies and gentlemen, this is the man that fought a great battle in a losing cause. And here at Madison Square Garden, a capacity crowd, for everyone concerned, this is Chris Schenkel saying so long from ringside.